ISO 9606-1 is different from EN 287-1 in a couple of very significant ways. Firstly, the base metal thickness has become a non-essential variable for butt welds, with the deposit thickness becoming the important thickness variable. Secondly, the base material type or group is no longer an essential variable for all but autogenous welding, with the filler material now becoming much more important. This short video shows how ISO 9606-1 certificates are created using TWI's WelderQual software. First, I'm going to create a new EN ISO document by selecting the relevant option from the drop-down menu. Notice that the software defaults to ISO 9606-1 for the qualification code, but I can select EN 287 if I want to create a document to the older code. Now, I'm going to select a welder from the drop-down list, and the software populates all the fields automatically from the welder profiles form. And now I'm going to select the job knowledge option and choose not tested. Next, you can see I have all three options for prolonging the certificate, and this is in addition to the 6-month confirmation. The first option is a 2-year revalidation, exactly the same as EN 287. If you use this method, you must be able to show your third-party representative 2 volumetric test reports for the welder and the certificate from the previous 6 months. ISO 9606 gives 2 additional methods, however, which are a 3-year retest, or if your company is already accredited to ISO 3834, it may not be necessary to revalidate the qualification at all, similar to the method currently employed by ASME Section 9. Beware in the UK though, because the BSI WE36 committee has added a national foreword to warn that the third method may not be acceptable to application standards and contract requirements. I'm going to select option B. Now, when I select the date of the test, the software automatically adds 2 years to generate the expiry date. I'll enter the other information as usual. The base material information is also added as before, but notice the option to carry out a combined fillet and butt test, which ISO 9606 allows, but only for backed butt welds. Now, I'll select the welding process and process type, and then the backing details. Note also the additional options for flux and gas backing and consumable insert. The software has now generated the ranges for base material type and thickness, and that means no range, because these are not essential anymore. I'll select the specification of the filler metal, and the program generates the filler metal group automatically, and then the range of approval. I could type or select the filler material group if I want to. As I've selected 111 MMA, I have 2 methods of specifying the type of covering, based on either AWSA 5.1 or ISO 2560-A. For a butt weld, the number of layers only becomes important if the deposit thickness is greater than 12 mm, so not in this case. But I'm going to specify 4 layers anyway. Next is the welding position. I'm going to specify HLO45, which gives me the widest range of qualification. Finally, notice that there is a new non-essential variable which must be recorded, in this case the current type and polarity. For gas-shielded processes, you'd also need to record the type of shielding gas, and for wire and rod processors, the type of consumable. And the remainder of the form is completed in exactly the same way as for EN287. Notice the new additions to the designation at the top of the certificate, which has been generated automatically. And that's all there is to it. As with all software inquiries, if you have any questions, please contact support@twisoftware.com. Thanks for your time.